Hi again. Today we're going to be taking a look at the all-new AC Infinity Ion Grid T22. We're going to take a look at the performance and the PAR maps in a 2x2, and two of these lights linked together in a 2x4. So if you guys are curious, stick around as we take a look at these lights' real-world performance. AC Infinity's recent entry into the lighting market has been impressive. Their all-new Ion Grid series offers a great feature set at a competitive price. No other lights in the market at this price point that we've seen offers the features that the AC Infinity brings to the table. Its unique halo design with driver placement and active aluminum heatsink cooling on the back really offers a great package for running cool in your tent. Plus the ability to remove the digital control unit and place outside the tent for remote control of your lights, and the ability to link up to four lights out of the box is truly a great feature for any grower. And the ability to program two separate schedules for veg and flower is an added bonus. That means you don't need another timer strip to control your lights. You can just program the controller and the light will do the rest. It has battery backup, so it won't forget your settings in the event of a power outage. If you guys missed the full unboxing and feature review, definitely go check that video out up on YouTube now. But today we're talking about real-world performance, light height, and dimmer settings. The Ion Grid T22 was designed for a 2x2 tent, but how much power can its 204 Samsung LM301B diode with a 100-watt driver, how much power is that actually putting down on your canopy? And what's the best height and dimmer settings for your plants through different stages of growth? I've done the measurements for you guys with the all-new Apogee MQ610 PAR meter with ePAR sensor. We've done the measurements at 24 inches, 18 inches, 14 inches, and 12 inches above canopy. We've taken these measurements with a single light in an AC Infinity 2x2 and two T22s linked together in a 2x4. So we'll be able to take a look at the performance at different heights and dimmer settings. Since the AC Infinity digital controller only allows light adjustments in increments of 10, this means there is no 75% or 25% like we would normally measure. So I decided to record the values at 100%, 70%, 50%, and 30%. I've also recorded the watt draw from the wall, so it's just a matter of turning it to that percentage and then setting the appropriate height to get that equivalent PAR. When you're looking at these charts, that's kind of how you'll decipher it. So let's dive into these numbers and take a look at the real world performance of the Ion Grid T22 from AC Infinity. Taking a look at the chart here in the middle, you'll notice that's the dimmer slash watt settings. So at that particular dimmer setting on the digital control, that's the watts you'll be drawing. Since it is a digital control and not analog, you don't really have control over what the wattage draw is at the percentage. So just match the dimmer to the percentage shown on the screen, and that should give you the equivalent PAR for the heights you're seeing here. And below that, you'll see the stage slash PAR recommendations. Those are recommended PAR outputs for plants at various stages from seedling, veg, and bloom. So as we can see from the chart, looking at the 24 inch height measurements, that's a perfect output from 30% to 100% to carry you from seedling stage all the way up into early veg. And here's a look at the measurements at 18 inches above the canopy. And at this height, it's perfect from 30% all the way to 100% for your seedlings and all the way up into the middle of your veg cycle. At 14 inches above canopy, we're just starting to get into that flower phase at 100%. So in this area, you can see the center's definitely getting enough power put down to start to flower your plants well, while the edges are just falling a little bit behind right on the borderline, but it's definitely gonna be enough power to get those flowers starting to grow. And at 12 inches from the canopy, typically I would just measure to 14 inches, but with this light and only having the limitation of a 100-watt driver and 204 chips on the panel, does put it at a disadvantage to some other lights on the market in the same price point. But there's definitely enough coverage here to start to flower your plants and finish them out well. But personally, I would have liked to see a little bit higher output from this panel. And I think if they would have done with a 150-watt driver and an extra 100 chips on the panel, they probably would have hit those numbers very easily, even at 14 inches. But with just a $119 price point and the features on this lamp that nothing else touches on the market right now in this segment, it's kind of a trade-off. So there's definitely benefits, but you might not get the power you need. If you're not a really expert grower who's growing the genetics to the limits of their capability, chances are you probably don't need over 1,000 PAR anyways, but if you're curious on the height that it took to get 1,050 PAR from the center reading, that was 7 inches above canopy. And here's what we have when we have two T22s linked together inside a 2x4. As you can see, excellent PAR coverage for the whole tent, and at 12 inches, that's great PAR numbers. It's definitely gonna flower out the whole 2x4 tent, and really an inexpensive option and a low power draw. So it's, you know, it's not putting out quite the PAR, but it's gonna be a cheaper electric bill every month, and it definitely has what it needs to get the job done. So all in all, the T22 is a great light with some amazing features. It does fall a little short in the power output compared to some other lights in the same price point, but when you look at the other features, the automation and how much it can help with your grow and just one less thing to worry about, it makes it a competitive option in the market that you should definitely consider, especially if you're a new grower. The price is low, the features are right. It's definitely gonna get your plants flowered out. You might not get the coverage of some more expensive or bigger lights on the market, but the features, it's hard to deny. They're nice. They're nice, and more lights should include what AC Infinity has done. Now, they also have other models coming up with higher power drivers, more chips on the panel, and the LM301H, which are a higher output than the LM301B. So I'm definitely curious to see how those lights perform. But this, as a 2x2 light and advertised at that bracket, it's a good option. And it's definitely gonna do what you need with a high quality build, great feature set. And two of these linked together do provide great coverage and performance in a 2x4 tent. So if that's your thing, definitely a T22 linked together with another light is going to give you some great performance. You can even go with one T22 with a better controller and then get the cheaper $89 S22 and link that to the T22. So you get the better controller, and your secondary light with the same output is going to cost you less. I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts on the new lights from AC Infinity and what they bring to the market. Do you think it's value added, or do you think they fell short of the mark? I know there's a lot of other light companies on the market, but really I think AC Infinity brings a new level and standard to quality in home growing equipment, from their fans to their tents. And now their lights, they've definitely raised the bar with what to expect in terms of a lighting product and its feature set. I'd love to hear your comments, so please comment below, guys. Let me know what you think of the T22 and AC Infinity's new lights. Are you gonna pick one up, or is it not enough for you? Thanks so much for watching, guys. We definitely do have a discount on all AC Infinity products. They do make, hands down, the best exhaust fans on the market for your grow tent. Definitely check them out. Use our code Highigan, save 15% on your order for anything from them. And it does go to help the channel here, so we really appreciate it, guys, because we put a lot of effort into our videos. Definitely check out us on Instagram. If you're curious about these PAR maps, they'll all be posted there, so you can review them in a little more detail directly from there. So thanks so much for watching, guys. We'll see you in the next one.